Hello everyone. As users, we always wish to have seamless user experience and user interfaces. If an application is too complicated to use and it doesn't provide us the expected experience, we will for sure discontinue using it. I thought of sharing a quick glance about the 10 usability heuristics by Jacob Nielsen, which I stumbled upon recently, and how we could use those to find usability flaws while testing. This heuristic serves as a rule of thumb which is applied for a wide range of user interfaces, and it helps to avoid the feeling of exception from our users. Before we start, let me quickly introduce myself. I'm Nitin and I currently live in Malaysia. I was born and raised in India, where I started my career in testing. Right now, I am fortunate enough to continue my passion by leading a wonderful team at Astro and building a community-driven co-writing space for testers. So without further ado, let's get started. So let me begin with this wonderful quote by Steve Jobs. If the user is having a problem, it is our problem. In order to make our users stick to our application, we should invest time in performing user testing and should keep our user interfaces easy to use. So remember, even though we are breaking this heuristic into smaller parts, all principles must work together to deliver a seamless user experience. Number one is visibility of the system status. So the design should always keep users informed about what is going on through appropriate feedback with a reasonable amount of time. So we should always ensure that we communicate the system state with our users. So say if you are seeing a progress bar while using an application, we know that something is happening in the background, and we should always provide our user information about what to do next. So communicating with the users build trust, and don't try to blindfold our users. Number two is match between system and the real world. So the design should speak the user's language, use words, phrases, and concepts familiar to the user rather than technical jargons. So we should always ensure that the user can understand what we mean without having to go and have a look at the dictionary or something. And never assume our understanding of words or concept matches those with the users. And we should always try to connect with real world interactions and options. Number three is control and freedom. So user control and user freedom. User often perform actions by mistake. They need a clearly marked emergency exit to leave unwanted action without having to go through an extended process. So we should always ensure that we provide an undo or redo option, a cancel option to exit the current interaction, and we should always ensure that the options are discoverable by the users. Never stop our users leaving our website by disabling a browser back button. Number four is consistency and standards. So users should not have to wonder whether different words, situations, or actions mean the same thing. So follow a similar pattern which follows the entire platform or industry conventions. So consistency and standards always plays a key role in creating application that makes sense to the users. So there are internal consistencies within a product or family of products, and we should always ensure about external consistency, which refers to established convention in the industry. Number five is error prevention. So good error messages are important, but the best designs carefully prevent problems from occurring in the first place. So we should always ensure that we eliminate error-prone conditions or check for them and prevent our users with the confirmation before they commit the action. So what we can do is we can provide helpful constraints. Say, for example, if it is a date picker, we can provide the acceptable dates in the calendar picker, which acts as a helpful constraint. If it is a search, we can provide auto suggestions when they key in some search keyword. We could use a good default, say for example, if it is a remainder app, whenever you add a remainder, it shows a default date, which is today. And we could provide options for formatting. When they key in mobile number, we can format based on the country or region. So always ensure that we have some sort of error prevention in place. Number six is recognition rather than recall. Minimize the user's memory load by making elements, actions, and options visible to them. So the user should not have to remember information from one part of the interface to the another one. So say for example, in Netflix, they have a recently viewed option which shows us all the recently viewed items. And from there, we can remind what we watched. And Amazon got a recent searches option where it shows all the relevant searches we did in past. And some application do have some sort of autofill. When we key in something, it captures suggestions based on the previously entered data and shows us. So these all interactions help us to reduce the memory load. And number 7 is flexibility and efficiency of use. And we could provide our users with shortcuts or accessibility options, which allows users to tailor frequent interactions. Say for example, in iPhone, we have gesture accelerator, which helps us to swipe through the keyboard and pre-fill the word which we want to type. And some applications do provide keyboard shortcuts, and we also have macros, which helps with the efficiency to use. Number 8 is aesthetic and minimalistic design. Interfaces should not contain information which is irrelevant or rarely needed. Every extra unit of information in an interface competes with the relevant units of information and diminishes their relative visibility. So we should avoid unnecessary elements that distract our users. Say for example, in this PPT, I reduced the number of content to keep the focus in what I wanted to deliver. So minimalistic design is something we should follow. Number 9 is help. Help users recognize, diagnose, and recover from errors. Error messages should be expressed in plain language, precisely indicating the problem and constructively suggesting a solution. Number 10 is documentation, help and documentation. It's best if the system doesn't need any additional explanation. However, it may be necessary to provide a documentation to help our users understand how to complete their task. So usability rules the web. Simply stated, if the customer cannot find a product, then he or she will not buy it. I know that this was too short and really quick. I would highly recommend you to go through all these resources once and maybe have a deep dive into those. With that said, thank you so much for listening to me, and I would like to thank the Test Drive community for always being creative and providing wonderful options to learn and evolve. Thank you.